We first met her 13 years ago on Australian Idol, where she was the youngest ever winner at just 16 years old. But it wasn't long before the Indigenous singer's career and love life hit some very hard times. This year, she's back on your radio and your TV with yet another big win. Casey Donovan is kind of Australia's reality TV darling, and she ain't giving up just yet.
It's Casey!
Now, 13 years after Idol, what made you want to go through that horror of being on reality TV again?
I have no idea. I was driving around doing Uber and I just thought, do I go on television and make a complete fool of myself? Or do I just, you know, stick to driving Uber and see what else comes around? And I sat with it for a while and I was like, you know what, stuff it, but it's two from two.
It's a good record.
It's a great record.
Now, just after you found out you won,
mm-hmm.
you got some pretty upsetting news about your family.
I think it was the day I came out of the jungle. I had a full day of media and my mum was over there and she brought up that my stepdad was diagnosed with stage one pancreatic cancer. You know, he's my rock. And to hear that news when I came out, I was devastated.
And how's that going at the moment?
Pancreatic cancer isn't curable, not at this stage, but they're doing everything they can to slow down the process.
Now, the Australian public did vote for you to win Idol, but 2 years later, you were dropped from your record label. People commented in the media at the time that you were dropped because you didn't fit the mould.
No, I didn't fit any moulds and I was a bit different, but I don't know. I don't, that may have played part of the role. It was never said to my face.
Over the past 10 years, you have had some different jobs. You've worked as an Uber driver, you've worked as a medical receptionist. I'm wondering whether during that time people recognised you in this everyday job and went, are you Casey Donovan? Did that happen?
That did happen, which was really weird when they were giving me their, you know, urine samples. You know, I think a lot of people, when I won Idol, just thought everything was going to be given to me on a, you know, a silver platter. But it wasn't that way. I've had to stop my life at so many points and go, what am I doing? What do I want to do? Is music what I want to do? And it wasn't at one point, so I went out, I got a job, I earned my keep, I was a little bit of a lost soul. I think it was about a year and a half I wasn't doing music. I got back into it working in Indigenous communities.
We do have our second ever young Indigenous person winning a big singing reality show, Isaiah Firebrace. What advice would you give him?
Stay true to himself. Remember where you come from and just do the best that you absolutely can do, because this industry it's tricky.
In the past, you've said that you're kind of proud of your Aboriginal heritage mm-hmm. and the white side of your family as well. Do you feel any different about your cultural identity as you've gotten older?
I think I understand my cultural identity more now than I did when I was 16. I always knew I was Indigenous and I had, you know, family and where my family was from, but I didn't know too much. So going through Idol and being asked about, you know, am I an Indigenous role model and all of these really big questions, I didn't really understand too much. I was like, oh, I don't know. I'm like to think I'm a role model for, you know, Indigenous and non-Indigenous. And
do you feel comfortable with being called an Indigenous singer these days?
Definitely. I mean, it's who I am. I mean, I can't brush it off. I can't wipe the colour off my arms, you know.
You do have a very divisive relationship with some parts of your family.
Mm-hmm. What,
has that improved over the years?
Definitely not. You know, coming from a broken home and not really seeing much of, you know, the Donovan family. When your family members tell you to change your surname, it's a very hard thing to hear. And to hear that coming out of I'm a Celebrity and finding out about my stepdad, that was fucking horrible. I had conversations, you know, is it time where I drop the Donovan name and just become someone else?
Now the catfishing experience. For something so painful and kind of out of the ordinary, what has made you want to go public with it?
I think a lot of it was healing for me.
At the height of Casey's Idol fame, she got a phone call from an admirer called Campbell that led to a 6-year relationship conducted solely on the phone. Casey eventually discovered the man on the phone was actually a woman she knew as Olga, who in real life had slowly become her closest friend.
There were many times where I ended that relationship, but because there was the person on the phone and also my best friend that I met through him reassuring me that he was real, that this is where he lived. You know, this guy had a Facebook family. There were people he was talking to. He spoke to my parents, he spoke to my friends, all over the phone. So I was in this ball of confusion and I didn't know how to get out.
And it was your first boyfriend?
It was my first boyfriend, yeah. So I was like, well, this guy loves me, he wants to be with me. It really mentally messed with my head. I felt stupid, I felt like a fool. And I didn't know how to get out. And, you know, there were points where I was like, I'm done in this world, I'm over it, I'm out. I was in a very dark, dark hole. The only thing that kind of brought me out was music.
Standing at your door, I'm shaking, we've been here before. There's no point trying anymore.
You just released a very personal single.
Yeah.
Lonely.
Yes, I have.
What is it all about?
Lonely is, you know, it's an account of a part of my life where I always end up as the friend in love. I was hurt and I didn't want to keep running back to that person and keep getting hurt over and over and, you know, with my my luck in relationships.
You wrote that you spiraled into a bit of sex addiction.
Look, I wouldn't say sex addiction. I'd say catching up on lost time.
Okay.
Maybe.
Too late to see you.
When you've been in a relationship with someone that's actually not real for 6 years, it was either that or drugs. And I picked sex. You?
Good choice. How is Casey Donovan's love life now?
God, a mess. you know, I've been so busy with work. I mean, I got back on Tinder.
Have you had a Tinder date since I'm a Celebrity?
I'm just trying to think if I've had a Tinder date. No, I think I've just gone back and reused a few.
If you could go back to you at 16, would you do the same thing that you did?
Definitely. In the last 13 years, there has been so many things that have happened to me, and I just gotta keep going and, you know, let people know that it's okay to fall down sometimes.
Casey, thanks for chatting to us today.
Thank you.